Good morning to all of you. Today is International Human Rights Day. You may be knowing the same and we celebrate it. Basically, on 10th December 1948, the United Nations Organization, which was established in 1945, declared the so-called Universal Declaration of Human Rights 1948. So, since it was declared on this day, recognizing the rights of human beings, we celebrate it, or we hail it, or we call it Human Rights Day, particularly International Human Rights Day. Not that human rights were not there prior to 1948, they were there. Right from the Magna Carta, 1215, King John I, yes, he is the person. Before him, I told you, the Cyrus Cylinder, the King of Cyrus, who has released all the prisoners of war, stating that they can actually practice or they can profess any religion they want at the time itself, before 1215, 600 BC. Like that, human rights were there, but they were codified by the United Nations in the framework of Universal Declaration of Human Rights 1948. And the first word, Rule 1, you should not forget. It was taken from UNO Declaration. We, the people, that means all the people are equal, all the people of the universe. The rules are meant for all the people in the universe. Likewise, you may be knowing, in India also, we enacted the Protection of Human Rights Act in 1993. Of course, it came into force on 8th January 1994. In this, according to Section 3, the human rights are defined as the fundamental rights enshrined in the Constitution of India and also the human rights enshrined in the international covenants like UDHR, International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, ICCPR, ICSCR, SEDA, so many things are there. And mostly importantly, which are enforceable by the courts in India. So that's why even in Section 30 and 31, 30 says there should be special human rights courts in every state, they have stated. Of course, in Andhra Pradesh, every first additional district and session judge court is designated as the human rights court. You can file a petition, you can get a recourse, or you can redress your grievance by filing a petition in the human rights court. Of course, normally people touch the doors of the high court when their human rights are violated as a remedial right under Article 226 of the Constitution of India, and they can file under Article 32 before the Supreme Court. Things are like that, it's going on. But as far as the state is concerned, Section 30 says there should be a designated court, and 31 says there should be a public prosecutor. But what happened is the ADJ courts are designated as the human rights courts, and the PPs there in the ADJ court, they are designated as the special public prosecutors, as a result of which they are not focusing their attention, or in other words, much attention is not being paid for the human rights activists and human rights issues also. Very minimal, because first ADJ already he is overburdened with POKSO Act cases, he is overburdened with Electricity Act cases, he is overburdened with NDPS Act cases, besides them some civil cases, besides that some murder cases or other trials entrusted by the district judge. Already it's overloaded, but still another court. Of course, even people are not aware to that extent to file petitions before the courts also. Anyway, so please remember, human right is nothing but an entitlement created by law. Please remember, law creates rights, obligations, and also duties. So don't forget. So simply think, don't think that you have got only rights, you have got obligations according to the Contract Act. Yes, you are, when you are entering into a contract, you are made to oblige or fulfill the obligations and duties. Yes, even the Constitution of India, Article 51A tells about so many 11 fundamental duties. All these things I don't remember. But anyway, human rights are now being considered as an important topic, and there are so many human rights activists In this connection, we have to appreciate the activities of so many non-governmental organizations. Also, of course, some of them are allegedly siphoning funds from other countries, and there are certain allegations, even some of them are closer like Amnesty International, but the human service by Indian Red Cross Congress, all these things you have to remember. So anyway, please remember or enforce the human rights of the other individuals. You may be knowing moral and legal rights, we are talking about legal rights only. In this connection, yesterday, a petition was filed by an NGO here, Guria Swayam Seva Samsthan. Guria Swayam Seva Samsthan before the Allahabad High Court. This belongs to state of UP. So they have filed a public writ petition. So this writ petition was, of course, yes, this NGO filed a writ petition requesting the Allahabad High Court to ensure that the states will actually enforce the Human Trafficking Act or Immoral Trafficking Act, Immoral Trafficking Prevention Act 1956, more effectively by adjudicating in more number of cases or by adjudicating more courts. So what they want is, they wanted to the establishment of special courts more in UP, because they have stated, they have given the figures, even they have cited the United Nations Office of the High Commissioner's report as regards to the drugs and crimes, drugs and crimes, because the human rights trafficking is still going on, and even this COVID-19 period also, human rights trafficking is going on, and they have placed the figures. They have actually stated, they have also filed before the court the several official documents and also studies made by so many NGOs. So they allege that no adequate steps are being taken by the government to combat such human trafficking. You know how serious it is, how bad it is also. So of course, what the court can do, they have given a notice to the state of UP. Even the matter has come before the CJI bench. Govinda Mathur and Piyush Agarwal, both of them, they have given notices to the state and asking for what action. Of course, the suggestion is good, because there should be establishment of more number of courts to deal with the human rights incidents, particularly the human rights trafficking. How bad it is. Suppose, have you seen the film Mahanadi, where Kamal Haasan acted? You'll be knowing how his daughter has been dragged into Sonarguchi of West Bengal. Young girl aged about 16 or 17 years. Innocently, she has fallen into the trap of this human rights gang, and it has taken her to Calcutta, and he goes to Calcutta and rescues her. Such is the problem. Of course, the persons who actually, they will get the feeling, they will actually, they will have the feeling, persons who lost their daughters or daughters-in-law, women, in this sex, flesh trade or human trafficking, they feel very bad, and you may be knowing their feelings also. And this should be curbed, and the act should be, of course, not only passing the act, but the thing is, the implementation is more important, and the quick remedial action, that is judgment, adjudication, should be there. For that, courts are necessary, and we will be happy if more number of courts come into existence to tackle the menace of human trafficking on this human day. Human Rights Day, please remember. So with this, I want to conclude, and please observe this as International Human Rights Day, and please propagate the human rights, because most of the people, they may not be able to aware the rights. Better, as advocates, you tell them about the human rights and the remedies, that is constitutional remedies like Article 32, 226, better you tell them, you have to propagate. Right. Thank you very much.